The Office of the Solicitor General, the Philippine National Police, and even the lawyer of Peter Jomel Advincula alias Bikoy all had one response to a report claiming the OSG had a hand in drafting Advincula's affidavit. There's nothing wrong, nothing unusual. ABS-CBN News reported Tuesday that two persons from the OSG authored and reviewed Advincula's affidavit based on an examination of the Microsoft Word document released by Advincula's camp to the media. In a statement, the OSG said it is the principal lawyer of the Republic and it has the legal duty to give legal advice to its clients, including the PNP Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, which lodged a sedition complaint against Vice President Lenny Robredo, former Senator Antonio Trillanes, and other opposition figures. But it refused to give further details, citing client-lawyer confidentiality. It clarified the PNP CIDG is its client, not Advincula. Both the PNP and Lorenzo Gadon, Advincula's lawyer, said the PNP CIDG merely consulted the OSG.
According to the director of CIDG, yung legal department ng CIDG had a consultation only, no? Had a consultation only with the legal department of OSG. Hindi sila ang gumawa, hindi sila ang nakialam dun sa no. It's but normal for us to seek advice and legal opinion from OSG. OSG being the sole counsel of all, legal counsel of all government entities and instrumentalities of our nation.
The clerical work was of course done by the CIDG. Now, if they have decided to consult the OSG after the documents were prepared, well, that's perfectly normal, you know. Because the OSG is the lawyer of CIDG. It will be a negligence on their part if they will not consult OSG. They might be held liable for any legal trouble that will arise in the future. That's why they have to consult.
But for former Solicitor General Florin Hilbay, assisting in the initiation of criminal complaints is outside the OSG's jurisdiction. He explains, in criminal cases, the OSG comes in only in the appellate stage.
Tanungin nyo yung lahat ng mga taga-OSG. They've never done anything of that sort. Nakakatakot, nakakabagabag, no, that the institution is being used to go after members of the opposition.
He adds, there might even be a problem if the OSG sides with a party early on in a case.
There's a conflict of interest because pagdating sa appeal, nakatali na yung position ng Office of the Solicitor General. Kung sa simula pa lang, may position na siya na ginawa at tumulong siya doon sa isa sa mga partido, ay wala na siya yung independence na sinasabi para magawa niya yung kanyang trabaho.
The government, Hilbay points out, cannot even use Advincula as a state witness.
Malinaw na hindi siya qualified dahil obviously he's the most guilty party dun sa lahat ng mga nakalista dun sa complaint.
Hilbay is one of the respondents in the sedition complaint along with Senator Risa Ontiveros. Both deny the allegations and accuse government of being behind the complaint.
Mahirap sabihin na walang koneksyon ang Office of the President sa Office of the Solgen, samantalang ang Solgen ang primary na abogado ng gobyerno at sinong pinakamataas sa gobyerno.
But regardless of whoever drafted the complaint affidavit, Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara says what's more important is whether PNP-CIDG's evidence will be able to support its allegations and establish probable cause against the respondents to warrant the filing of criminal cases in court. ABS-CBN News sought to get the side of Robredo and Trillanes, but both have yet to respond. Mike Navallo, ABS-CBN News.